In this video here, I will show you 5 chromatic arpeggios that you can use over dominant 7th chords, and you can use it for blues or jazz or any style in music. Okay, let's go to the different arpeggios. The first arpeggio is the flat 7 major 3 arpeggio. You start here with the flat 7 in the 3rd fret. So go up to the major 3rd from the flat 7. Continue to the flat 7, so from the major 3rd, then you continue from the flat 7 to the major 3rd, and then up to the flat 7, so the whole line. Okay, the next one is the 1-5 chromatic arpeggio for A7. So we start here, go up to 5, and then we have to go up to 1 from 5. Yeah, but in this case here we have to slide up to the 5 because we have to continue the line. So, yeah, and then we go up to the 5th from the 1 here, okay, yeah, and then we go up to the 1, so the whole line. And the next one is the major 3rd to the flat 7. So major 3rd up to flat 7 to major 3rd. And then up to flat 7. And then major 3rd. I like this line here. It's nice. The next one is the 5-1 chromatic arpeggio for A7. So we start here in the 12th fret with our pinky. So I use some slides here. So first I go up and then I shift to the first finger here from my pinky in the 12th fret on the A string to the D string in the 11th fret with my pinky, and then I'll go up. Yeah, so I go up to the 5 and then I have to hit the 1. And here I use my finger here, I bar the A and the C sharp, so it's the 3rd and the 2nd string, and it's in the 14th fret. So I go up from A to the 5, so A, C sharp, D, can say D sharp, E, yeah, the whole line. Yeah, so you can try to use the 5 different chromatic arpeggios and try to use them. For example, start with a blues and you can, for example, play it over all the 5 chords in a blues. So yeah, if you play a blues in D, you can use this arpeggio for the A7, the 5 chord in a D blues. You can also use it in an A blues and play them over the 1 chord. Sounds very good. And yeah, try to take maybe one position and then you can go to another position and yeah, find your way to practice this, and then you will get some vocabulary into your playing. And it's also very good for your technique, because you have to make different shifts with your fingers and you use all 4 fingers, and there is also some slides and good stuffs, and you can come up with some lines when you have been doing this for a time. You can try to say, okay, now I will try to make some lines just on the high strings. Okay, can I do something here? Okay, maybe I can do this here too. Yeah.